With the internet, knowledge is easily in our reach. With one swipe and a tap, we can find whatever we need. Unfortunately, not all knowledge shared online is true. Without prior knowledge, how would we know what is true? Follow along as we learn how we can trump out fake news. But before we go on, make a quick guess, which is true and which is fake? Psych, the two pieces of news on the right are fake.
With the rise of social media and rapid dissemination of information, fake news is gaining popularity to attract users as a way to generate online advertising revenue, promote products, or promote an ideology. Despite social media sites changing their policies to curb the spread of fake news, we still see many interacting with such news. Many people face difficulty in differentiating fake news from real news. What if we could identify news that is fake before it reaches people's screens? To do so, we have come up with three questions to guide us to our goal. What are the most important features in identifying fake news? Which model best identifies fake news? And whether there are distinct differences between real and fake news? Now, you might wonder, what is a model? And no, we are not referring to the people walking down the runway.
Simply put, a model is a learner. As seen from this example of red and blue triangles, the model learns from the data by recognizing patterns. Afterwards, we use this model to predict results in previously unseen cases. For our project, the data that we feed to the models are news, both true and fake. The model will run through the data and predict whether a particular news article is true or fake. We'll make use of many machine learning models and learning methods to determine which is the best in classifying true and fake news.
So far, what has our team accomplished? From our data, we generated three types of features for both the title and the text. The first feature is the number of exclamation and question marks, the second is the number of capital words, and the third is the number of profanities. We also generated a TF-IDF which reflects the importance of each word in the document. After training various models, some including TF-IDF as a feature and others excluding it, we found out that logistic regression model with TF-IDF has the highest F0.5 score, which is a score that places more emphasis in ensuring that fake news is not wrongly classified as true news. What then can we conclude from this? Based on the data we have collected so far, it looks like the number of capital words in the title is most likely to inform you if your news is real or fake.
To recap, fake and real news can be tough to tell apart, but models can help us out. Not all features are made equal. Some are more important than others to tell us whether a piece of news is true or fake. What we have shared today is just our preliminary results, and we aim to further analyze the impact of training our models with uncommon features. We hope that you've learned a thing or two about what models can do, and you'll feel inspired to find out more.